Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint an appliance. I tend to buy an appliance for its function and then just paint it to match my decor, rather than buy an appliance that looks good but doesn't have the functionality that I would like. Here are the tools I use in this video. Our family needed a new toaster and we found several on Amazon. The one on the left had the color scheme I liked, but the one on the right had the functionality. They were the exact same price. So I bought the one on the right with a plan to paint it. To paint something metal or plastic, it's best to use an oil-based paint because it's less likely to peel off than latex. It's ideal to prepare the metal or plastic surface to make the oil-based paint stick well. I sanded the sides of our toaster with 220 grit sandpaper. Any medium grit sandpaper will work well. You just want to scuff it up a bit to make the paint stick better. And you want to sand in the same direction as any existing grain in case the paint is thin and shows the scuffs. I don't use primer. I've found that if I prime my work with a primer, the outer paint might scratch off, and then I'm left with patches that show the primer. I've stopped priming things, and I just paint the color that I want right on the metal. I've had good luck with Rust-Oleum paints, so that's what I'm using here. And I don't like spray paint because even though I've worked on projects with spray paint for years, I always spray too much and end up with globs that drip and run. So I buy paint in cans and mix it to get the right color. Clean the surface with acetone or rubbing alcohol to remove any oil. If you have touched it with your hands and left oily residue, the paint won't stick properly and is more likely to come off. Cover your work surface with something to protect it. Select an oil paint color that you like, or mix a few to get a color. If you plan to add glitter, don't do it at this point. It will just get mixed into the paint and covered by the paint. I use a foam brush because they don't leave streaks like bristle brushes do. Foam brushes are also very inexpensive and disposable. You don't have to spend time cleaning the oil paint off when you're done. Paint in the same direction as the grain so the strokes are not obvious when the paint dries. If one coat seems thick enough, let it dry. Once it's dry, you can remove the painter's tape. Leave your appliance to dry for 24 hours. In this case, it means no toast for my family for a day. You can be finished at this point, but I wanted glitter and a glossier coat, so I went on to the next step. Tape again. Make sure the power cord is out of the way. This time you really don't want epoxy on your cord. This is the epoxy I used. You mix it in equal parts by volume, not by weight. Part A is denser than part B. I used gloves and mixed the epoxy. I tried two separate mixtures to see if it mattered whether I added the glitter at the beginning or later in the mixture. It did not matter. I applied the epoxy and glitter using a silicone makeup brush. Epoxy doesn't stick well to silicone, so it's easy to clean the brush off when you're finished. All you need to clean the silicone brush is rubbing alcohol. It takes quite a while for the epoxy to dry. You'll occasionally need to keep removing extra epoxy that drips. Wait about 3 hours and then you can remove the tape. You definitely don't want to wait more than about 5 hours because then the tape will be stuck in the hardened epoxy. Now your work is done. Set your appliance aside for another 24 hours and let the epoxy dry before you use it. If you have questions or suggestions, please enter them into the comments below. Please tell me about your appliances that you have painted. And please like and subscribe so that you can watch me paint even crazier things. Thanks for watching.